Well, it does burn out.
So if everything goes exactly as planned, this go-kart's gonna be doing a burnout by the end of the day.
We got several key components in. We got our starter recoil. We also got the bolts to attach it, because if you remember in the last video, we were pulling that cord and it broke. It was already a little janky, so that's getting replaced. We also got our axle back. This thing is beautifully machined. Just look at that thing. An absolute beaut. And then we also took over some of these keys to the machine shop and had them cut down. I'll get more into that later.
Start with the easy stuff first and just look at how beautiful this thing is.
The next step's gonna be to remove this axle here, and I'm gonna throw keyways in both these little hubs, and I need to throw keyways where these sprockets go. And then I also have these locking collars which need attached to the axle, and that's what's gonna keep that axle from being able to float side to side and lock it in.
The original go-kart had a 6mm keyway on this axle, so the hubs and the brake caliper all also have a 6mm key cutout in them.
Now the sprockets I'm using to connect both the axles together have 8mm keyway cutouts in them, so I needed a key that adapted from 8mm down to the 6.
Which is why I had the machine shop cut this keyway down so it adapts from 8mm down here to 6mm up here.
I had to do the exact same thing on the sprocket that is attached to the engine. I had to adapt from 7mm down to 3/16 inches.
I have a feeling that this is gonna take a little bit, but enjoy this montage as I get these axles fully assembled and on the cart. Time to get rid of what you guys have been calling the Mad Max axle.
I've never been so excited and yet so scared to start an engine in my entire life. Well, it does burn out. That proves it. This thing will do a burnout, shoot up that brand new tire. I'm gonna call it broken in now. Now in the next couple videos, we're gonna be building a guard for that chain because that is dangerous. Don't want it ripping off my leg. We also need a chain tensioner for it, and we still need to get those pedals in. Now click one of the boxes if you wanna see the playlist of this whole build series and see how we got this go-kart up to this point. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you on the next one.